Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the CLR and LALR1 parsers. The objective of today's class is to understand the algorithms involved in construction of CLR and LALR1 grammars. Okay. So these two grammars, they are related to the bottom-up parsing and they both make use of LR1 grammar. Okay, we normally call it as LR1 item. That means they are going to use LR0 grammars plus one look ahead symbol. That is the next symbol which the parser is to read is only one symbol at a time. Okay, parser is going to store only the next successive element which is of one symbol. Okay, not a group of symbols, only one look ahead symbol at a time will be stored by the parser. The full form of CLR is canonical LR parsing method. Okay, and the full form of LALR is look ahead LR technique. So among CLR and LALR, LALR grammar or the parsing table of LALR is much simpler and smaller than the CLR table. We can generate the parse tree by using both CLR and LALR, but when we compare both, LALR is much easier to construct the parsing table as well as to generate the parse tree. Okay, and one more advantage of LALR1 grammar is most of the syntactic constructs of programming languages can be expressed conveniently by LALR1 grammars. Okay, so always LALR is used or it is preferred more than CLR grammars. And all the productions which we use under CLR or LALR, they are of this type. A goes to alpha, beta are two non-terminals. And we have dot operator which indicates that the symbol which is before dot indicates that it is already read by the parser, and the symbol after dot indicates that this is a non-terminal which the parser has to read. Okay. It is not yet read by the parser. And then we have a comma followed by some letters or terminal values. These are called as look ahead symbol. Look ahead symbol in the sense, what is the first of the non-terminal, okay, whichever we are going to read, whichever we are going to construct the look ahead symbol for that. Okay, for the non-terminals, we have to compute the first over the non-terminals, then we get the look ahead symbol. Okay, this we will see when we do the problem. Okay, so this is a sample problem which is related to the construction of CLR parsing table. So here we have been given with a CLR parsing table. CLR grammar is given to us. We have to generate the DFA diagram and then we have to construct a parsing table. So first we will look at the procedure of how to generate the DFA diagram over this. So here what do we do is, to the given productions, whatever is given to the question, to these productions we add an augmented grammar. Augmented grammar in the sense, here E is the start symbol. To this start symbol we add one more non-production that will generate this start symbol. Okay, so these are the productions which we use. This 1, 2, 3 are the productions which are given in the question. E produces BB, B produces CB and B produces T, and small c, small d are the terminals over here. To these productions we are adding an augmented grammar, that is E dash produces E. This is an augmented grammar. So by using the same procedure as we have done in LR parsing, here we are going to generate the canonical set of items or DFA diagram as shown here. So the first step is to generate the DFA diagram. Okay, or we also call it as a canonical set of items. Okay, by adding an augmented grammar. So first we will start with E dash produces dot E. E dash produces dot E means before E we are keeping dot. That means the parser can read this dot E. It has to read dot E. Dot is before before this non-terminal E, means E is not read by the parser till now. It has to read that one. So here it is writing dot E. And coming to the look ahead symbol, since this is a start symbol, here by default we have to write dollar because there won't be any look ahead for the start symbol. Then we have to produce, okay, we have to derive what is the extension of this non-terminal. We have to write those right side production of E. What is the right side production of E which is given to us? It is EBB. So under EBB, this is a extension of the start symbol E. So that we are going to write. And since dot is before capital E, that means when parser has not read capital E, that means it has not read what is the extension of the capital E also. So that's why dot is kept before BB. So here one thing we have to keep in mind is we have to write the look ahead symbols properly. Now how to write the look ahead symbol here is, okay, so here we are writing E and B. So initially if you have any production value like this, suppose we are having a production value like this, S goes to AB. Okay, since this is a, okay, we have some start symbol over here. Okay, we have some look ahead symbol over here. Okay, this is dot A. This is one type of production. This is just an example. So this parser has to read A. Even though there are plenty of non-terminal values or symbols after this first A, we don't consider all those things. We have to extend only this capital A. So that capital A we have to write. Okay, what is capital A? It may be some small A that we are going to write. Okay, after writing this, we have to extend. Okay, we have to put dot before this, because since capital A is not read, its extension is also not read by the compiler or the parser. So here we have dot A, and then here we have to write the look ahead symbol. Now what is our look ahead symbol? What look ahead symbol we have to write here? That is our question. Okay, so when we are writing the look ahead symbol for this, the look ahead symbol is taken from the previous statement. So within a same state, okay, I repeat, if it is within a same state, the look ahead symbol for this will be the, it has to be taken from the previous production value. So we have to write the look ahead symbol of the non-terminal which is following A. Okay, this is the actual, this is the production which the parser has to read now. It has to start reading from A. So after, so this will be the current symbol which the parser has to read. Then this capital B will be the look ahead symbol. So this look ahead symbol we can't write directly here, okay, this, because this is a non-terminal. So for that purpose we have to take what is the first of B. Okay, compute first of B. Okay, and we have to write the first of B may be small b, then we will write look ahead symbol will be B in this place. In case, okay, one more example we have. Okay, same production. If the example is in this way, or suppose the production is in this way, okay, there is some state I not here. This is one more state I1. Okay, we have some production S dot A, where this S is some start symbol. We have some look ahead. For start symbols, we have the look ahead dollar. Now, current symbol. Okay, current symbol we have to extend like this. The A current symbol is there, we have extended. So here also, we are extending. Then we have to write the look ahead symbol. What is the look ahead symbol? The symbol which is following this current non-terminal. What do we have after this? We don't have anything here. There is no B. So in that case, we can't apply first for that one. Okay, we can't apply first because there is no symbol after this A. Then what do? We have to take whatever look ahead is there above that we have to write. So this will be the look ahead for this state. Okay. In this way, we have to write the look ahead. If there is any successive element for the current symbol which the parser has to read, then we have to take the first of that symbol. Okay, we have to find out what is the first of that particular non-terminal B. If there is no non-terminal after a particular current symbol, then we have to take the look ahead of whatever statement is there here, the before symbol, same look ahead we have to take over here. So that is the procedure we follow here. Okay, so same thing we are doing here. So E dash is there, take dot E. Okay, this is a start symbol, so we have dollar as a look ahead symbol by default. And then extend E. What is the extension of E? Is dot BB, comma. Now what should be the look ahead symbol here? The look ahead symbol will be the first of the non-terminal which is after capital E. Since after capital E there is no non-terminal here, I am taking whatever dollar is here from the previous statement, I am taking and I am writing over here. Okay, just like our second example, whatever we have seen, there is no non-terminal over here. We have to write the look ahead symbol which is here. So that we are writing. Okay. Then again you check after dot there is a non-terminal. Whenever there is a non-terminal, we have to extend it. Okay. Again. So again extend this capital B. First B we have to extend. So what is the value of capital B? What is its extension? Extension is small c b or small d. So that we are writing, and since dot is before this first B, we have to put dot before this starting of these two productions. And now the question is, after writing these productions, what should be the look ahead? So here, after the present symbol which we are elaborating, we have no non-terminal. One non-terminal is here. Here, when we are elaborating E, there is no non-terminal. So we have borrowed this dollar as it is. But for this third statement, when we are extending capital B, we have a non-terminal. So whenever a non-terminal is there, B, we have to compute first for this non-terminal value. This will become the successive element for this next for this present B. For this present first B. So what is the first of capital B? First of capital B is first letter, okay, first terminal value of this production and first terminal value of this production. So we get C or D. So that we are writing as a look ahead. And now again you check this one. After dot we have a terminal, and here also after dot we have a terminal. If it is a non-terminal, again we have to write its extension after this production as a fourth line. But since these two are terminals, no need to write any extensions. Whenever after dot there is a terminal, don't write any extension. Now consider this as one single state. Okay, we can just name it as I naught state. Now again elaborate this one. E is there, elaborate E. E goes to E dash, goes to E dash, produces. Okay, when the parser read E, dot will move after E. So after E it is there, and whatever look ahead is there, when you are taking this a particular instruction, particular grammar rule to the next state, whatever look ahead is there, same look ahead is also copied in the next state. So I1 is taken. Now extend B. Okay, now once the parser read B, this dot will move after the first B. So we are getting B dot B, and this look ahead will be copied as it is in this production. Okay, when we are taking the a particular production from a state, then after dot there is a non-terminal here, so we have to extend this. So when we extend, we get like this, that is dot CB or dot D. And what should be the look ahead for this? Look ahead should be the symbol, the first of the non-terminal, which is after the current variable. What is the current variable we are extending? We are extending this B. This B is what? This second B. Okay, whatever dot is there, after dot, whatever non-terminal is there, that we have to extend. So here capital B is there, that we have extended. This is our current symbol. What is the successive of that? There is no successive element. When there is no successive non-terminal after this, we have to take the production. We have to take the look ahead symbol as it is from the previous statement. So here dollar will be the look ahead symbol. Then again extend small c. After reading small c, dot will be after small c. Capital B, comma C or D. And again check, after dot there is a terminal or non-terminal. If non-terminal is there, again you have to write extension. If terminal is there, no need to write any extension. So take B again, write down the productions of B with the dot before B is there. So we have to write dot before this right set productions. Dot CB, dot D. After this, what should be the look ahead symbol for this? Okay, this is our current symbol. What is the successive element of B? No element is here. So copy this as it is. C comma D is copied as it is as a look ahead. So similarly D. Okay. So we have extended C here. We have taken B produces CB here for this first one. Then take the next production, B produces D. When D is read, it becomes B dot, B produces D dot. And after dot, there is no non-terminal. So there is no chance of any extension. So this is the end. This is the final item. Any production which is having dot at the right side production, and after dot if you don't have any terminal or non-terminal, it means this is called as final item. There is no more extension for this state. Similarly, this is also final item. Now check this one. These two are not final items, because after dot there is some terminal or non-terminal is there, which we have to extend it until we get a final item. So take the first statement, extend the second B. Now if second B is read, it becomes C produces BB dot. This look ahead will be taken as it is from the previous state. Whenever you are taking the first statement from any given state. So after dot, we don't have any non-terminal to extend. So this is the end. So then look ahead symbol will be same as it is, copy dollar. Then again read CB. When you read CB, it becomes C dot B. C dot B. The look ahead will be copied as it is if you are taking the production from the previous state. Okay, then again, after dot we have a non-terminal. There will be an extension for this non-terminal. What is the extension of B? Dot CB or dot D. and after this current symbol there is no non terminal, there is no successive element for this capital B. So whatever look ahead is there after this production, same look ahead will be copied over here. Okay, similarly D, if you extend, it becomes B produces G dot comma dollar. Dollar will be copied as it is. Okay, when you extend like this, then you have to check whether look ahead will be same or not. But when you are copying the first statement directly from this, look ahead will be same. Okay, so I2 is extended in these three ways. Okay, three states we got. Similarly, if you extend this one, okay, we have to extend with B, we have to extend with C and D also. Extend B, we get B produces C B dot. After dot, we don't have anything to expand. Okay, no non-terminal is there, so this is end of the production. Then write down the look ahead symbol. Look ahead symbol is what? Since we are taking the first statement as it is, look ahead will be C or D only. Whatever is there here, same thing will be here. And then extend C. Okay, when you extend CB, if you observe again, you will get the same thing. When C is red, okay, again we get C dot B, and the look ahead which is there in this, okay, will be same look ahead here. Okay, because you are taking this first statement as it is to the next state, again you will get the same state. So that is why it is kept as a loop. Then again read D. When you read D, look ahead is C or D here itself. Okay, here also same thing, C or D. So again same set of production values and look ahead you will obtain when you extend there. I3 state with D, so it is again connected with the same state I4. Okay, so these three states have been extended, I1 I2 I3. Okay, so this set of states, okay, second level is completed. This is the first level. Okay, then this is a second level. Then extend this in a similar way, we got I5. Then if you extend with a small c, same procedure, we get I6. Extend with D, we get I7, and extend here BCD, you get I8, I3 and I4. Okay, so this is a final item, this is a final item, this is also final item. Why? Because after dot, we don't have any variables to read. So this is the only one pending. So again, if you extend, capital B is here. The next symbol which we have to read is, after dot, whatever is it that we have to extend. So after dot, we have this capital B. So capital B, if you extend, we get CB dot. After this, there is no non-terminal, that means this is the final item. And if you extend this one, okay, if you start reading C over here, again you get the same state I6, so it is kept as a loop. And if you extend this one, okay, so dot will move after D dot, and this look ahead will be same, so we get the D dot dollar. So this will be the I7. So again, there is no more extension. So our okay, so this was only non-final which we have extended, okay, and this became the final with B. Okay, so C will be in loop only. We never get any final item when we go on extending C. When we go with the D production, we got a final item. Okay, so there is no scope to extend still further. So this has been completed with our first step. Second step is to number the productions. How to number the productions? Whatever question is given to us, okay, from the start symbol, we have to write the same thing as it is. So start symbol production is there. Okay, that we have to write. The order in which it was given, this is a start symbol. We write E produces BB as a equation 1, B produces CB as equation 2, B produces D as equation 3. This is augmented grammar which we have taken for our convenience to draw the DFA diagram. So for this production, don't give any number. Then our next step is to construct the parsing table. Okay, the procedure is same as we have done in LR grammar. So this is how we do in the constructing the parsing table. So how do we write the parsing table here is, first we take all the states, whatever we obtained in this DFA diagram, we have totally 9 states. Okay, we have action part and go to part. In the action part, we write the shift and reduce operations under the terminals. So write down all the terminals which we have in the given production is, and the terminals are C and D that we have written, and dollar should be written by default. And go to, okay, go to indicates states which the non-terminals are being shifted. Okay, so capital E and capital B are the two non-terminals which we have taken here. Now write on, based upon each and every state, we are going to write I0 with E. Okay, it has moved to one state. I0 with B, it has moved to I2 state. So we can write this I1, I2, I3, all this numbering we can give above these states. Okay, okay, before the this circle, outside the circle we can give. So 1 and 2 we have written, and when we have extended C, we have moved to I3 state. So when we are dealing with the terminals, we have to write S3 instead of 3 and 4. Okay, similar to the LR parsing table. And then when we have extended D, we got I4. So here we are writing S4. S implements shift operation. We are shifting C to I3, D to I4. Okay, then come to each end. The next set of states, I1, I2, I3 we will see. I1 is E produces E dot. E produces E dot is, it is a start symbol is completely red. So that means this is accepted. So at, in the place of dollar symbol, we have to write accept. Dollar is meant only for the start symbol. So here we write the accept. Then go for I2. I2 have three extensions B, C and D. So when B is red, it is going to I5. That, so we will write only 5. Don't write S5. Only 5. Then we take small c, it is going to 6, state 6, S6, D is 7, so it is S7. Similarly, I3 if you take, B is going to 8. Okay, then C is going to same state, that is 3 only. D is going to I4, that is S4. Okay, that we are writing. Okay, so these three sets of states are finished. Now coming to this four states, next level, I5, I6, I7, I8. So, I4 is also there. I4 is, okay, we'll come back to the I4. This is the final set of states. So this is a state R4. So coming to the state I4. So under I4 we have D. B produces D. It is related to 3, where this production is completely reduced. And locate symbol is CD. So under CD we write R3. And I5 is BB. This is completely reduced. This is equation 1. So we write the reduced. 1 is reduced. And the look ahead symbol is dollar. So under dollar we write R1. Then I6. I6 is a state where there is no final item. So here there are only shift operation. We have capital B. Capital B is going to state 9. Okay. So here we write I6. We write 9. And I7. And small c, it is going to S6 and D is going to 7 state, S7. Okay, then we have the I7 state. Under I7, this is completely reduced. This is equation number 3. So R3 we should write, and we should write under the look ahead dollar, under dollar R3. And I8 is here. I8 is completely reduced. The equation number 2, it is R2, look ahead is CD. So under C and D, here we have to write R2. And the final state is I9. Then CB production is says this is related to equation number 2. So this complete state is called as reduced state of equation 2, that is R2. Look at symbol is dollar. Under dollar we have to write R2. So this is a complete parsing table for the CLR. Same procedure is applied for LALR also. Okay. Now coming to the LALR. So here what we are going to do is the DFD diagrams, what we use under CLR and LALR is whatever states are there, whichever are the production rules on the right side, if anything is repeated, that we are going to merge as one single state. Okay, like suppose we have I3 state and I6 state, we have C dot B. And here we have dot CB and dot D. Similarly, here also same productions are repeated in I3 and I6. But look ahead are different. So what we are doing is we are trying to combine them as a single state. Okay. So coming here, C, it is written as CB and dot CB dot D. These the right side productions are same. But look ahead here are CD here and in 6 it is dollar. So we are combining the look ahead symbols, okay, under one particular group. So all the look ahead symbols are added over here. CD dollar, CD dollar. Okay. So same procedure, but we are slightly changing the diagram. So whatever C is going to I6, here instead of going to I6, it goes to this new state I3, which is named as I36. Okay. So here I2, it is going to which C it is going to I6. So here again same productions and look at symbol is also there dollar. Okay. So instead of going to I6, it goes to this state I36. Similarly, I4 and I7 is here. I4, I7, it is D dot D dot. Look ahead symbols are two different types. So add them all together as one look ahead symbol, that is CD dollar. And here we are writing it as I47. Similarly, we have I 8 and 9. This is CB. This is also CB, but here CB and CB is set. Here CD, CRD is look ahead and dollar is look ahead. So we will combine the look ahead also into one single stage, that is I 8 9. So that we are writing. So remaining predictions are same as it is. So this is a LALR. In LALR, we try to reduce the number of states. Okay, in order to develop the LALR, what we have to do is first we have to draw the same set of DFA which we have drawn for CLR. Among this, we have to identify which states are common. Then we have to combine those states. So this will be the first step in our LALR. Then the second step is to just reduce the number of states in this way. Okay, combine the states which are having same type of productions and combine all the look ahead symbols in the different states as one type of look ahead symbols. Okay, so this is how we try to draw the LALR parsing DFA diagrams. Then how to fill up the parsing table now. Now in order to construct the parsing table, okay, the procedure is again same. Okay, now here instead of writing as different states, okay, so we have written the different states over here. So let me show you the two states, okay, whatever we have seen. Okay, so these are the two different states. So this is for, we have the CLR. This is CLR parsing table and this is LALR one. Okay, so how to write? So again we are going to write same set of states. Procedure is again same. So instead of I3 and I6, we are writing it as one single state I36. Instead of I4, I7 separately, we are writing I47. I8, I9 instead of separately, we are writing it as I8, I9 as one single state. And remaining set of the things which we have written here will be same. And look ahead symbols, okay, since we are combining all the look ahead symbols, C, D and dollar. So instead of R3, okay, I4 and 7, we have R3. And here we have combined the look ahead symbol dollar. So under I47 we have R3 and R3. I5 is single state. I6 is combined with I3. Okay. So there is no reduce operation here. So here instead of S3 we will write S36. Instead of S4 we will write S47. So wherever 4 is there we have to write 47. 3 is there 36. Or 6 is there we have to write 36. Okay. Similarly I8 we see. Here we have R2 and I9 R2. So combine all these look ahead symbols, we get here R2 R2 R2. So this is the procedure how we will write. 8 is there, we have combined with state 9, so this will be 8 9 as one single state. So this is how we write the LALR table. So and we, you see the number of the states in the parsing table here, the number of states have decreased and the table is also very simple. So that is why LALR is more preferred than CLR. So the outcome of today's class is student will be able to construct the parsing table using CLR1 and LR1 grammar for any given production rules. Okay. So this is about the comparison between the CLR1 and LLR1. Thank you.